What if the key to understanding the universe lay not in the heavens above, but in the quiet arc of a curve drawn in sand over 2,000 years ago? Today, we measure space with satellites, navigate with GPS, and model the fabric of space-time itself. But every revolution has its first sketch, and one of the earliest, most elegant strokes came from a man whose name history nearly allowed to fade into silence, Menaechmus. He didn't sail across seas or lead armies into battle. He did something far more profound. He discovered the conic sections, curves that would later guide the orbits of planets, describe the paths of comets, and give rise to entire branches of mathematics, physics, and astronomy. This is the story of a forgotten genius who shaped the very language of space. The sun-drenched marble courtyards of classical Greece gave birth to a generation of thinkers who would challenge everything the world believed about reality: Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, Euclid. Among them, quietly working in the shadows of giants, was Menaechmus. Born around 380 BC, likely in Allopokinesis, a town in Thrace near the Aegean coast, Menaechmus lived during one of the most intellectually explosive eras in human history. He was a student of Plato, the philosopher who declared that geometry was a divine language, one that could unveil eternal truths. But he wasn't content with mere theory. He was a mathematician of the real and the curved, a mind who dared to look at shapes in ways no one else had. To solve a problem that had baffled minds for centuries, the Delian problem, or the doubling of the cube, Menaechmus invented an entirely new way of thinking. The ancient Greeks had received a challenge from the Oracle of Delphi: double the volume of a cube using only a compass and straightedge. An impossible task, at least by those tools. But Menaechmus approached the problem geometrically rather than ritually. He realized that the solution lay not in construction, but in intersection. By intersecting two conic curves, he solved the problem by discovering the precise relationship needed to double the cube's volume. This wasn't just a solution. It was a revelation. In the process, he had discovered and defined the parabola, the ellipse, and the hyperbola, shapes carved by slicing a cone at different angles. Though it may have seemed like a mathematical trick at the time, these curves would become some of the most important in the history of science. Though Menaechmus was among the most famous contributors, he was not alone. Archytas of Tarentum also worked on the problem, using three-dimensional geometric constructions involving cylinders and cones. Their approaches, though different, both revealed the universe of spatial reasoning far ahead of their time. Check the video about the story of Archytas in the channel or above. Centuries later, Kepler would describe planetary orbits using ellipses. Galileo would use parabolas to describe the motion of falling objects. Einstein's very field equations would rely on these shapes to describe gravity itself. But it all began with a man in a cone, and a question about a cube. Menaechmus didn't work in isolation. He was a student of Plato, but more remarkably, a tutor to Alexander the Great. Historical anecdotes suggest that when young Alexander demanded shortcuts to learning geometry, Menaechmus replied with a quiet boldness, "There is no royal road to geometry." This wasn't just a rebuke. It was a declaration of the value of effort, reason, and truth over privilege. In those few words, he defended the purity of intellectual pursuit, even in the face of imperial power. Despite his achievements, he never wrote a treatise that survived the fires of time. We know him primarily through the works of others, Proclus, Eutocius, and Plutarch, ancient chroniclers who revered his contributions. His conic sections would be formalized much later by Apollonius of Perga, often called the Great Geometer, who gave these curves their names and expanded on their properties. But Apollonius stood on the shoulders of Menaechmus. And through these shapes, Menaechmus became a ghostly architect of the future. The mathematics that began with slicing a cone would go on to guide planetary mechanics, optics, architecture, satellite trajectories, and modern physics. These curves aren't just abstract lines. They are the paths of the cosmos. They are the silent signatures left by the forces of nature. Even in modern times, engineers calculating rocket trajectories, astronomers predicting the paths of asteroids, and physicists simulating the behavior of particles, all owe a quiet debt to Menaechmus. He left no school, no monument, no surviving book. Every time a spacecraft loops around a planet, every time a physicist models the gravity of a black hole, every time we trace a curve through the fabric of space-time. And he showed us that sometimes, to see the universe clearly, you have to look at it sideways. He wasn't remembered as loudly as Archimedes or Pythagoras. But Menaechmus changed our world, quietly, indelibly. He turned an altar into an equation, a riddle into a revelation, a cone into the language of the cosmos. And today, every satellite launched, every planet tracked, every arc traced across the stars, echoes the insight of a man who saw not chaos, but curve. Because sometimes, the shortest path to the infinite isn't a line. It's a curve.